This is Clay King from AAA Flood Drying, and we have a wet ceiling that's wet from a water damage situation here, and water has leaked from an upstairs pipe incident, and we're going to attempt to dry this ceiling out. And one of the ways that we're going to do this is we're going to hook up a section of layflat hose to this recessed light, and then we're going to hook that lay flat hose up to this air mover, and we're going to drive air up into the ceiling, and we're going to show how we go about hooking that up so that we can dry your ceiling out without tearing the ceiling apart. All right, I've removed the bezel and I've removed the light bulb. There's just some springs that hold them in. Then you have this can right here that goes up into the ceiling that holds the light. And then right here, there's a screw. And there are generally three of these screws that hold this metal can into place. So we're going to take a screwdriver or a nut driver, and we're going to take these screws out, save them, and then push this up inside so we can access the void up above the ceiling. So now the light fixture is unscrewed. I'm just going to reach up inside here and push the light fixture to the side. And now I have an unobstructed hole, and this hole goes up into the entire void above this ceiling. And generally, at least here in New England, the way these ceilings are installed is there's strapping running this way on the ceiling, and the joists are running in this direction, so that there's a 3/4 inch undulating space that ties this whole ceiling area together. So if we can get air into this hole, we can dry this ceiling in here and ceilings in other rooms just from one hole. Sometimes we use more than one hole to drive more pressure and more air. And we can put either heat, just air, or we can duct a dehumidifier up into one of these holes. What I do is I get an old-fashioned metal coat hanger, and this is the coat hanger here. And this coat hanger was just a metal coat hanger, and I straightened it out and cut it, and then I just twisted it together with a pair of pliers, and you can see the twist in it. And just used 2 pair of pliers and twisted it up. And I constructed this ring so that it's about 1/2 inch bigger than this hole. So it actually won't fit up into the hole. It's a little bit larger. And that's the whole idea, is that this ring should be a little bit larger than the hole so that it'll hold the lay flat securely into place. And I'll show you how we hook that up next. This is lay flat tubing. This is a plastic pipe that comes in a roll. It's very similar to like a sandwich bag plastic. It's about the same thickness as maybe like freezer grade sandwich bags. And it comes flat on this roll. And it's about 22 inches end to end when it's flat. And that's why it's called lay flat. It's because it lays flat. You can see it laying flat on the floor. And what we do is we take the lay flat and we roll some out, and then we attach the metal ring to the lay flat. And so we take the ring, and what we're going to do is we're going to pull the lay flat through this metal ring. So now I've put the lay flat through the ring, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to fold this plastic around the outside of the ring. So the plastic comes up the center of the ring and then folds over the outside all the way around until this ring is just in the end of the plastic tube. Now the ring is installed in the plastic, and you can see right down inside, and the ring is in the end. And this will hold tightly up into the ceiling. What I'm going to do is I'm going to crush this ring and kind of make it look like a football. So I'm going to make it oblong, and then I'm going to push it up through the hole in like a football shape so that it doesn't dent or scratch the ceiling. And then it will spring back the amount that it takes to make it round again. And then I tug down on it and it seals it. So now I'm going to push this up into the hole while making it like a football shape. And then I'm going to try and center it in the hole and pull down on it evenly all the way around. And I'm going to double check with my fingers that the ring is in about the right spot. And when I pull down, it should hold up in the hole and not come out. And I just keep adjusting it until I feel that it's right. Now there's no plastic going up beyond that hole. It's just going into the hole about a half an inch, and that's it. So there's no obstruction. So the airflow is pretty unrestricted. So you get a lot of airflow out of this. So now the plastic is installed in the ceiling and the lay flat is coming down to the floor. And I put my blower directly underneath where it's going to go up. And I run the lay flat pretty much to the floor. And I'm going to cut it off almost at the floor, because when this expands with air, it's going to shorten a little bit. So I need to have a little bit extra. All right, at this point, I've installed the lay flat on the blower. And I've used blue preservation tape. It's a plastic tape. You can get it from Dr. Shrink or from John Don. And works very well for sticking to plastic. And we wrap it around the blower a couple of times and pull it real tight. And then we leave a little tail, so when you want to go take it off, you can actually find the end to get the stuff off. Otherwise, it's pretty brutal to remove because it works so well. So this is plastic preservation tape from Dr. Shrink. And we've installed the lay flat on here, and you can see that it's delivering a lot of air. It's not just a little 4-inch tube. This is 14 inches around when it's full of air, and it's a straight shot straight up to the ceiling and into the hole. And so it's the maximum width of that hole. And one of the things that happens is if you leave it the right length, it actually seals also up against the ceiling and it just pulls tight. You can see it pop and seal. It's kind of neat. You have to make sure that when you do this, that there isn't a twist into this hose. If you twist the hose, that hole will tend to be smaller. So you've got to take this entire thing and turn the blower a little bit until the twist comes out of this tube and you have the full flow going up into the hole. So right now, I'm pretty much pushing 1200 CFM of dry air up into that hole above the ceiling. So it's drying anything that could be damp. The entire ceiling or anything else that could be up there, including the subfloor and the subfloor underneath a hardwood floor that's upstairs. So this does a very, very good job at drying out ceilings. And we've used this quite a number of times, and it works very efficiently. So it works very well. And this is one of the setups that we use when we're drying ceilings out, and it works very well, and it can save a ceiling, and it can save a tremendous amount of demolition that you would normally have to do to dry out a ceiling. So this is one of our methods, and if you have a wet ceiling that you need to have dried, we can come and hook this up and save your ceiling so that you don't have to rip it out and replace it. Clay King, AAA Flood Drying.